Welcome to the mathematics class. This class is for class 7 and previously we were doing chapter 2, that was decimals and fractions. So this class is in continuation with decimal and fractions, and we have discussed till the topic multiplication. Now we will discuss about division of decimals. So first we will discuss division of decimals by whole numbers, and then we will discuss second topic will be division of decimals by decimals. So let's take an example. Let's take 1020.48 divided by 8. So what we need to do, we normalize, we do the division process as we have been doing. And what we'll do, finally we line up the decimal point in question. Let's see how it is. So 8, 1's a 8. How much is left? 2. 2 carry down 22. 8, 2's a 16. So it will come 6 and 0, 16. Now 8 sevens are 56. What is left? 4. Now you will find a decimal over here. So what we will do, this after 20, this decimal will be aligned with this quotient like this. And then we will proceed. 44. So 8 fives are 40. And 4, we carry down 8. 8 6 is 48. So what you need to remember, that decimal, when we are dividing, you divide it in a proper manner, and only at the place of decimal in the quotient we place the decimal. This is the way how we divide the decimal number by whole numbers. Now let us say we have to divide decimal by a decimal. So what we will do, let us take 8.304 divided by 5.19. Now what we do in this, if you have a question like this where the denominator is also a decimal, then generally we multiply the denominator by the powers of 10 to make this as a, to make the denominator as a whole number. Means if I multiply 5.19 by 100, I will get 519. So this will become a whole number. And in order to not to change the whole decimal, not to change the whole question, if we are multiplying in the denominator, we have to multiply to the denominator by the same powers of 10. Means in this question, what I will do, I will multiply 8.304 upon 5.19. This is multiplied by 100, 5.19. At the same time, the numerator will also be multiplied by 100. So when you multiply by 100, this decimal shifts two places towards the right. That is 830.4 upon 519. And then, so now this question converts into this form. It was 1020.48 divided by 8. Now this question converts to this form. Now simple, you divide 519, we'll divide 830.4, and whatever will be the value, that will be the answer. Let's see. 519.830.4. So 1 times 519. 10 minus 9 is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1, and 8 minus 5 is 3. We carry down 4, but the 4 is after the decimal, 4 is there after the decimal. So this decimal will be aligned with the quotient, that is this, and I think it will be 6 times. So because 9 6 are 54 and we need 4, so 6 9 6 are 54, 5, 6 and 6, 4, 11, 9, 6 are 51, 6 and 5, 11, 1, 1, 6, 5 is 30 and 131. So the final value is 1.6. That is the final value. This is how we use division process, or this is the basic method that is given in your book. When we divide decimals by whole numbers and when we divide decimals by decimals. Let's see what is the next topic. I hope all the topics have been covered. And now we'll be moving on to exercise. That will be exercise 2C. I'll be discussing some problems on the board. And I expect everybody to write those questions, those problems in your FAIR notebook. Whatever questions will be left, that will be done by you all in your practice register. Now I have taken question number 6. In this, the question reads, write these fractions in with denominator 100 and express them as decimals. Now I am talking about 1 upon 20. 25 is 100. I have to convert the denominator as 100. So it means I have to multiply it by 5. If 5 is multiplied to the denominator, then it has to be multiplied by numerator also, so that the fraction or the ratio does not change. So it becomes 5 upon 100. Similarly, 1 upon 25, we know that 25, 4 size 100, so multiply the denominator by 4. If denominator is multiplied by 4, then multiply the numerator also by 4. So it will become 4 upon 100. Similarly, 7 upon 20 will be multiplied by 5 and 5. Means 7 5 is 35 upon 25 is 100. Similarly, 11 upon 25, so 25 folds are, so we multiply the denominator by 4. If we are multiplying the denominator by 4, we have to multiply the numerator also by 4. So it is 44 upon 100. Now the decimal value will be, in this it will be 0.05. You can see 500 means 0.05. Now this will be 0.04. This will be 0.35 and this will be 0.44. This is, we have done the sixth question. Means first you have converted each of the fractions with the denominators 100 and then later on we have converted them to the decimal part. Now next question is question number 7 I am taking, and there are 4 parts. I am doing the third and the fourth. So third question reads, subtract 25.009 from 37.8058. Now in this, you have to subtract this from this. So we are doing it by vertical method. So this will come on the top and this will come below. 37.8058 will come on the top and 25.007 will come below this number. So we can write it as 37.8058 and 25.009. Please check one thing, that decimals, I told in the previous lecture also, the decimals need to be aligned. So you can see decimals are coming one below other. Irrespective of how many digits are there after decimals. Here there are 3 digits, here there are 4 digits, but it hardly matters. It doesn't matter at all. The thing is that decimals should be below each other. Now if nothing is there, we can assume that here it is 0. 8 minus 0 is 8. 9 and 6 is 15. So 9 minus 0 is 9. And this is 7. And again put a decimal. So this will be 7 minus 5 is 2. And this is this. This is the final answer. Now I am doing the fourth part. The fourth part is 749.5684 from, you have to subtract from 1040.09. Now here there are only 2 decimal places and here there are up to 4 decimal places. But from this, so this will come on the top, this will come below. So 1040.09 and 749.5684. What we need to remember, that decimal should come under the decimal. Decimals needs to be, the decimal point needs to be aligned. Now here nothing is there, so we can assume that it is a 0 and it is a 0. Now 10 minus 4 is 6, this is 9, 9 minus 8 is 1, this is 8, 8 minus 6 is 2, and 10 minus 5 is 5. Now this is 9 minus 9 is 0, this is 3, the 9 and 4, and 9 minus 7 is 2. So this is the final value. So this is the final value. We have discussed two questions. Now we will be discussing question number 8, and in that also we will discuss two parts. Now I have taken question number 8. In this we will be discussing two parts. First is 7th part, and then we will be discussing the 12th part. What is the 7th part? Multiply 0.25 by 0.008. So what you will do? We have already discussed, let's say 0.25 into 0.008. Suppose this way. You want, you can write this on the top and this below, because 2 into 3 is also 6 and 3 into 2 is also 6. So it hardly matters what comes on the top or what comes below, it doesn't matter. Now 8 5s are 40, 4 carry, 8 to the 16 and 4 20. And then it was a decimal. We are not going to put any decimal anywhere. Now 0. So 1, 2. 0 into 5 is 0. 0 into 2 is 0. And 0 into 0 is 0. Now again with 0. 0 into 5 is 0. 0 into 2 is 0. Then we, this is 0, 0, 2, 0. Now we will count the total number of decimals. Total number of decimals is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It means in the answer or in the final value, there should be 5 digits after the decimal, or decimal will be placed 5 digits towards the left. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth, from where to bring the fifth? Just put a 0 and then place a decimal, and here you get place a decimal. So it means the final value is 0.002. These zeros either you write or you don't write, it never make any difference. So this is the final value, means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But final value you can write is after just only 3, because these zeros, suppose I write rupees 20, it means rupees 20 means 20.00 paise. Or suppose I say 2 centimeter, 2 centimeter means 2.0000, n number of zeros you can put. So after decimal, the zeros are not counted. So that is why it was 0.00200. But I have written, I have taken as 002, because these tools are of no use. So we can write the answer like this also. Now let's move on to the next question. That is 423.16 into 3.78. So first of all, we multiply 423.16 into 3.78. Now let's see the multiplication. 8 6 are 48, 4, 8 and 4, 12, 2, 8 3 is 24, 25, 2, 16, 18, 1, 30, 32, 33. This is the first multiplication, 423.16 into 8. Now we multiply by 7. So 7 6 are 42, 4, 7 4 11, 7 is 21, 22, 7 is 14, 16, 6, 7 goes at 29. Now, simple multiplication we are doing. 3, 6 is 18, 3 was a 3, 1, 4, 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 2 is a 6, 3, 2 is a 12. Now we add all these values. So 8, 4, 4, 5, 1 carry 10, 16, 3, 19, 9, 1, 10, 6, 16, 3, 19, 9, 1, 4, 1, 5, and 1. Now this is the multiplication process. Now where to put the decimal? We'll count the total number of places. So 1, 2, 3, 4 total digits in the answer will come, the decimal will come after the 4 digits from the right towards the left. So 1, 2, 3, 4 means decimal has to come at this place. So this is the final value. That's it. Now I have taken question number 12. Now what is the question? Saurabh bought some toys. Of rupees some toys or toothbrush. In the book it is written toothbrush. So Saurabh bought some toothbrush for rupees 43.95. He gave rupees 100 to the shopkeeper. How much he got back? So suppose you are going to the market purchasing something of rupees 43.95. You give shopkeeper rupees 100. How much will he return back? Simple subtraction. So what you can do? He bought back. That is rupees 100 minus rupees 43.95. So that you have to show in the working. So 100.00, because here it is 43.95. So what I have done, it was only rupees 100. Only rupees 100. So rupees 100 can be said as 100 rupees and 0 paise, or because there is in the second value it is 0.95 paise. So you need to mention here how much paise is there. So we have written 0 paise. Now 10 minus 5 is 5. Simply subtract. 9 minus 9 is 0. 9 minus 3 is 6. 9 minus 4 is 5. So he got how much rupees back? Rupees 56 and 5 paise. 0.5 means 5 paise. If it would have been 0.50, it means 50 paise. But here it is 0.05. So it means he got back 56 rupees and 5 paise. Now the second thing is, if the cost of each toothbrush is rupees 14.65, find the number of toothbrush he bought. So number of toothbrush, I'm writing toys to avoid writing too much. So number of toothbrush will be total amount paid divided by cost of each. So 43.95 is divided by 14.65. Now just now we have studied, when there is a division of decimal by a decimal, the denominator is changed to the whole number. So in order to remove this decimal, we will multiply this by 100. So we are multiplying the denominator by 100. And when we are multiplying denominator by 100, it is important or it is mandatory to multiply the numerator also by the same value, so that the fraction does not change. So it is by 100. So final value will get 4395 upon 1465. Now let's see by dividing. So 1465 divides 4395. Now 14 threes are, you know, is 42. So if we try by 3, I hope this will divide. So 3. 3 5s are 15, 1 carry, 18, 1 19, 1 carry, 4 3s are 12 and 13, 3, 3 1s are 3, 1, 4. It means total number of toothbrush he bought for rupees 43.95 is 3 toothbrush. I hope this is understood by you. Please see, if you have any doubt, please go through the video once or twice again, so that your concept will be clear. Now to question number 13. Now question number 13, its language is a little bit complicated. That is why I have written the whole question. They say the largest square that can be drawn in a circle largest square that can be drawn in a circle. Let's say this is a circle, and in that we are drawing a square. The largest square that can be drawn in a circle has a side. This is the side. Has a side whose length is 0.07 of the diameter. So diameter of the circle is, let's say D is the diameter. So they say that side is, I'll write it here, they say that side of a square is 0.707 of diameter. Or D, that is D, represented in the figure by D. Find the length of the largest square that can be drawn in a circle of diameter 5.2. Now, if this is a circle whose diameter is D, it means that a square that can be drawn inside this, its side will be 0.707 into D. Now, if in the same circle the diameter is given as 5.2, so the side of the square will be 0.707 into 5.2. Means here you have to use the multiplication. Only they are checking whether you know the multiplication of decimals or not. So now I hope we can multiply it. I'm writing it here. It is 0.707 into 5.2. We multiply. So 7 2s are 14. 7 2s are 14. 5 7s are 35. 5 7s are 35. So 4, 5, 1, 6, 4, 3, 7, 5, 1, 6, and 3. So how many decimal places that numbers or digits the decimal will appear? 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm moving from right towards left. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3.6. So final value comes out. The side of the square will be 3.6764. That is the final value. I hope this is understood. Now we move on to question number 14. Question number 14 says, Mrs. Gupta had 24.36 meters in cloth. She made 9 dresses using 2.14 meters each. Remaining cloth she used in making 3 shirts. Find how much cloth she used in making each shirt. Means, she had this much meters of cloth and she is using each for making 9 dresses. So first of all, we will find out how much cloth was utilized in making 9 dresses. So my statement will be, cloth used in making 9 dresses, that will be 2.14 into 9, because in each dress she is using 2.14 meters and she is making 9 dresses. So total how much cloth will be used? 2.14 into 9. So I am doing it horizontally. 9 4s are 36, 3 carry, 9 1s are 9 and 3, 12, 2, 1 carry, 9 1s are 18, 1, 19. So 19.26 meters cloth has been already utilized. Now we will see cloth left. How much cloth is left? She had total of 24.36 and how much she has utilized? 19.26. So minus 19.26. So 6 minus 6 is 0, 3 minus 2 is 1, 4 minus 14 minus 7 is 5, and that's all. 5.10 meters. Or you can say simply 5.1 meters cloth is left with her. Now with this 5.1 meter, she is using this much length of the cloth in making 3 shirts. So how much cloth is used in making one shirt? So we will say cloth used in making a shirt. That will be total cloth is 5.1 meters and she is using this total in making 3 shirts. It means we will divide by 3. Now you can see it is a whole number. So when you divide it is 17 or 1.7 meters. If we divide it here as a rough 5.1 divided by 3. So 3 ones are 3. 2 is left. Now decimal is there. So we'll place the decimal and then we'll carry down 1. So 21, 3 sevens is 21. So it is 1.7 meters. So how much cloth was used in making each shirt? That is 1.7 meters. Now the last question, question number 15. So all these questions that we have done on the board, you are supposed to write in your notebooks. Okay. The question number 15 says, in 1 mile there are 1.6 kilometers. You have to find out how many miles are there in 135.28 kilometers. So very simple, number of miles in 135.28 kilometers will be 135.28 divided by 1.6. Simply they are checking whether you have understood the process of division by process of division of the decimals by decimals or not. So what we are going to do in this, we will convert this into a whole number. To convert this denominator 1.6 into whole number, we will multiply the denominator by 10. So what I am doing, multiplying the denominator by 10. If I multiply the denominator by 10, then it is mandatory that I have to multiply the numerator also by 10. So I am doing the same process in the numerator. It will become now 1352.8 divided by 16. Now we will divide it in a rough. Let's say this is my rough. So 16 we are dividing 1352.8. So I think it will divide by 8. 6 is 48, 4, 6 and 8, 4, 12, 128. Now 8, 15 minus 8 is 7. Now nothing is left. You carry down 2. So we carry down 2. So let's see. 16 4s are 6 4s are 24, 2 64. Now 8 and 4 12. Now there is a decimal point, so we will put the decimal after 4 and carry down 8. So 16 5s are is 80 and then 8 is carried down after decimal. We can place a 0, so 80. So 5 again and 80. Now nothing is left. It means how many kilometers are, how many miles are there? 84.55 miles are there in 135.28 kilometers. This was my rough portion. So this will come into your rough column. You have to show this division in the rough column on the right hand side as we keep on doing. So this completes your exercise, and next topic will be approximation of decimals. That will be coming in the next class. Please keep on studying. In case you have any doubt, please comment in the comment section. I will try to reply, and please do all the work that has been assigned to you, right? And at the end, I would like to say like, subscribe and share, and so that your friends also can be helped by this. Anyway, thank you all of you.